these down, keep it from rolling backward. Put some shocks in front of the wheel so keep it from going forward. Nose is light. I'm kind of hoping that this will pump a little bit of oil through the engine. It's probably not much, but it's something, especially up here in the valve areas, because there's a It's hidden under here. There's a fuel line that comes up through here that put pressurized oil into the where the valve seats are, the valve stems. As far as I can tell, the lower part of it is splash lubricated. The cam and so forth. The oil pump's right here. And you can see the push rods tubes here that come right down in that same general area. So I don't know quite enough about the lubrication system to see if it's pressure oiled on the bottom. I don't think it is. Okay, I don't see any leaks, oil, fuel. Spark plugs, make sure the caps are tight. I haven't had any problem with that, so that's good. Yeah. Well, I experimentally cut some foam pads for headrest. They're just temporarily taped on there, but it's about the right height for shorter and taller people, and looks like maybe it needs to be a bit thicker. Just seeing how it fits with my own head, you know. So this is a climb in and put your feet on the seat type of thing. Sit up on this shelf, and then I reach down and put my hands on the armrest as I slide myself down in. Get down into a squatting position and then slide my legs in. So it's kind of an acrobatic type of thing, but not bad once I'm in here. And getting in the back is similar in that you just slide all the way back on this surface here. It's reinforced. Slide all the way back, swing your legs around and down into the hole, and you can stand in there and then get yourself down in the seats without any big problem. Okay, this is basically what I do to start it up. Turn the power on here, and that closes a solenoid back there on the firewall. Turn my key on, and I'm going to just go to on and not go to start. It's like an automotive key switch. Left is accessory, off, on, and start. So it's very much like starting a car. I do have a rocker switch right above the key switch, and what it does is it turns off the left or the right ignition system as a test once it's running, so that I can tell that one or the other is defective if it is. Okay. The HTX 1100 is booting up here. I just did an update on the software yesterday. Actually, not the system software, but the obstructions and maps and so forth that the government updates once a month. So that includes things like airport information, stuff like that. Okay, Our parameter's saying we're at about 850 feet. We're really at about 940. So, inversely, that means we're at about 29.89 inches barometric pressure. Normally, you would just plug in that value, turn the barometer setting until you got that value, and it'll give you your altitude. So, I've added a bottom scale here to give me, and I haven't been using this, gives me left and right gallons in the tanks, which are empty. I have about 2 gallons in each header tank, and that's not indicated on this lower banner. But this is a manifold pressure, tachometer, main gallons per hour, and it says 8.8 gallons remaining. I need to reset that. Okay, going back to key switch on. And up here, we're seeing a low battery complaint from the engine control unit. It's looking for, I think it's 13.4 volts minimum. And actual measured off the battery is 12.2. So that's why that's complaining. That'll go off when the alternator brings the battery voltage up to 13.4, and that way I'll know that the alternator is working properly. Plus, I'll see this negative current go positive, probably several amps to begin with, and then drop off. Okay, when we start the engine, we want to see fuel pressure right away of between 35 and 55 pounds, and we want to see oil pressure right away at least 14.5 pounds. And while we're warming up, we'll be watching oil temperature and cylinder head temperature. This chart is showing all 6 cylinders. It's going to show cylinder head temperatures over here on top of the exhaust gas temperatures. And it'll be more obvious when we get to see it. Okay, so we've got the master on. Key switch is on. Oh, after I get it started, I'm also going to check the left and right side on the ignition too at about 1500 RPM. Okay, so after we're fully booted up, key switch off, leave the battery power on and select left fuel tank. That's battery power. It's a backup battery on this. So we're booted up. We're going to go to key switch off, select the left fuel tank, turn the key switch back on. You have the fuel pump running back there. Fuel pressure from that pump right now is 48. And that's working against a regulator, which holds it at 43. Okay, so we're going to go key switch off again. Switch over to the other tank. And turn key switch on. Hear the pump running? Getting 49 pounds out of one out of the right tank pump. And stabilized at 43, 42, that's fine. Okay. So we've got our pressure. So we're going to open the throttle about 10%. Turn the key switch to start and see if it'll run. Really cold, so it'll take a little while. Cylinder head temperatures up here. This is exhaust gas temperature down here. See the blue starting to show up here. That's our cylinder head temperature. Blue is. This is our digital readout of it. You notice our battery complaint has gone away because our battery voltage is at 13.6 now.
amp charge going on, battery charged back up. Over here, this is indicating that our right fuel pump is running. Actually, it's indicating that there is power to the right fuel pump. See the warning is here. Okay, our left fuel tank level is low, which it is. It can be. We're running on the header tanks. Canopy contact is high. The latch and canopy goes away. So our left brake levels are low, landing brake contact is high because the landing brake is disconnected. And we need to compass calibration. Can't do that until we enter an airport.
Okay, we've got fuel pressure. Crank the throttle 10%. Clear the prop.